26%. I'm very glad to be here in front of you and present this work in progress with Liliana Suárez, also a professor at the University Autónoma de Madrid. We are dealing with one of the most difficult questions for migrants. It's the question of the sense of belonging. I hear this Maria from Mexico saying this word, to belong, that's the most difficult, I think, for a migrant. It's very hard. It's very hard to say where I belong to for a migrant sometimes. According to Levi-Strauss, identity is an indispensable virtual home which helps us to explain a certain number of things, but which never truly exists. We address this complex issue, and I will start with a brief overview of the theoretical questions around this thing and explain our research with one survey that we are performing to migrants in separate diverse areas in Spain. It's a elusive question, but a body of research has developed to capture its social expressions. The old concept of assimilation has lost significance today. We cannot see this complete abandonment of attachment to the society of origin. This dichotomic situation, whether you are from your country of origin or you are assimilated in the host society. Migrants today feel at home in several different social spheres, speak several languages, participate in cross-border social networks, and sometimes they make a living with international economic activities. This is well studied in the literature. Sometimes assimilationist perspectives tend to value exclusive positions. We found that this hyphenate identity, so when people combine these references to both a foreign country and a host country, it's like seen sometimes as a negative or uncompleted process of integration. Behind this logic underlays this conception of fixed stock. It means that if you have a sense of belonging with another country, automatically leads to corresponding weakening of the sense of Frenchness or Spanishness or this identity with your host society. It is also well known that this is not the situation. International social cultural practices are well identified. Our first hypothesis is that we won't have an effect of the feeling of belonging to the country of origin over the feeling of belonging to the host country. I didn't explain yet the data and which our variables actually. I'm going to explain it later, but we have two main dependent variables. We are measuring, I will explain later, but the sense of belonging to the host country, in this case, Spain. If you feel belonging to Spain, you feel Spaniard. The feeling of belonging to your country of origin. This is our two main variables. We expect no effect according to the literature. If you are feeling strongly attached to Spain, it doesn't mean we won't expect any effect on the attachment to the country of origin, which would indicate this transnational multiple complex identities of migrants today in Spain. Other expectations that we have, Portes and others show that transnational entrepreneurs have strong connections with their countries of origin. Migrants with higher income, education, language skills are more likely to be able to choose transnational activism and to be linked to both societies. we expect migrants with higher income level and college education to be more prone to keep significant sense of belonging with the country of origin and also with the host country. So that's education level have an effect on these variables. That is also what we are expecting to find. Also, time of residence is well documented to have an effect. We expect time of residence to be negatively associated with identification with the country of origin, meaning that if you are staying here for a long time, this attachment to your origins are fading out. Reversely, positively associated with the host country, meaning that you just arrived, so your feeling of attachment to Spain is expected to be weak, controlling by all the variables. Portes and others have identified age as a retarding factor of adaptation among foreign-born, but they couldn't identify it separately of the time of residence because the data they were using. So we are expecting to find, we can do that. So we are expecting also to be independent effects, so age and time of residence, meaning that if you come here older, you will have a stronger feeling of attachment to your country of origin, and reversely, a weaker feeling of attachment to Spain, independently of the time of residence you are in here. So younger generation is expected to be more affected by the experience of migration in terms of this feeling of attachment. And finally, we expect also to be confirmed this hypothesis in the literature dealing with this discrimination and experiences of stigmatization and othering that migrants can experience in the host society. So we expect that if they experience discrimination, they will have a weaker feeling of attachment to the host society. And also, if they perceive the host society as a more xenophobic society, also their feeling of attachment to Spain will be weaker, and also the opposite. We also expect the opposite, taking into account these studies of reactive identities, because and others, that if you are feeling discriminated in Spain, for instance, they will be more attached to the country of origin. This is our expectation. The data we use, I talked before, is this intercultural coexistence at local level in Spain in 2017. We included questions that allow us to relate international identification with these variables that we are studying. A total of more than 2,600 personal interviews face-to-face were carried out in 25 highly diverse territories in Spain. I can talk to you later about the characteristics of these territories and some. Our dependent variables, feeling of belonging to the host country and the country of origin, were taken from the following phrases. To what extent do you feel you belong to the following groups? Do you feel Spaniard? Do you feel so the name of for the people from the country of origin that we covered before? So you feel Spaniard? Do you feel Peruvian? And the answers were taken from four categories: a great deal, a lot, very little, not at all. So we constructed a dichotomic variable from the first two, meaning a significant feeling of attachment, a lot or a great deal, and not significant feeling of attachment with not at all or very little. So this is our first result for the sense of belonging to the host country, in this case Spain. No effect effect of feeling of belonging to the country of origin over the feeling of belonging to Spain was found. So we confirm this hypothesis of no matter how attached you are to your country of origin, you can develop this attachment to Spain. So they are independent. A higher income level and college education have no significant effect. We didn't find effect. So this is something to discuss, and we point into this digital nomad mobility type. So that we are also in the second Bible talking about. Time in Spain is shown as a key factor in the feeling of Spanish. It's confirmed. Additionally, as Portes and others have predicted, age appears to be a determining factor of identification and assimilation. So these two variables are having an effect separately, as I talked before. So if you are older and you come to Spain, you are having less prone to feel attached to Spanish, even if the time of residence is equal to a younger generation. Feeling discriminated against for being a foreigner, and perceiving that immigration evoked negative feelings for most of their neighbors, deters foreign-born persons from having a significant feeling of belonging to the host society. And I think it's important to know that this sense of belonging is not affected by the impact level of the economic crisis, the economic crisis that we had in Spain, maybe we still have. So the strong economic crisis is how we measure this, is not affecting the feeling of belonging. So they will be less attached to the whole society if they feel discriminated, but it seems not to have an effect how the crisis affected you. Having children is having an effect, and also interesting reaching effect. So we have these variables capturing where the migrant was born, in which region. We have Eastern Europe, Maghreb, Sub-Saharan Africa, Asia, Latin America, and Western Europe, the United States is controlled here. And what we find, it's a question to debate, is that there is an effect, we receive an effect from Latin America, Asia, and Sub-Saharan Africa to they develop a stronger feeling of attachment to Spain than other regions, other the control region. And this second variable, this sense of belonging to the country of origin, we found also this confirmed that is not having an effect. If you feel Spanish, you can feel also Peruvian or your country of origin. It's not having an effect. It's not a fixed stock, as some of the literature from this assimilationist perspective suggests. Time of residence, as expected, is negatively associated with identification with the country of origin. As time goes by, you start feeling less attached to that country. And age is positively associated with identification with this country of origin. Even if time goes by, I become here older, there is always a place in my heart for this country of origin. This is not so much the case for the younger generations. Migrants with college education are less prone to express a significant affiliation to their country of origin. So it's not what we expected. It's pointing to this, mainly this digital nomad type of mobility literature, meaning that more people with more skills, college education, are more able to adapt and to forget these origins. Even if these effects are not very strong, this is something that I will comment now at Importantly, no significant difference between regional quality and QPD. This is were found. This is something to discuss. Sense of belonging to the society of origin is independent to having experienced discrimination or xenophobia. This is also very, very interesting. So we found these variables affecting this host country, Dutchman. So there is a lot of things that condition and influence if you are feeling Spanish or you're feeling French or Norwegian. That's what we expected that it's not only the case for Spain, but for other countries. So a lot of variables affect this attachment to the whole society, but when we're speaking about the country of origin attachment, almost non-variable seems to have an effect. It seems like this is a universal feeling of attachment to the origin, no matter if you feel discriminated or not, no matter if things will go to you in the country of origin, in the host country or not. It's not really important if you have children or not. It's not really important which region of origin you have. So all regions of origin, all migrants seem to have an attachment to the whole, to the country of origin, independently if they feel discriminated or not, if the crisis affected you or not. So it's not like a refuge feeling. It's not a reactive identity as was found to be in the second generation, in the next generation. So we discussed that for the first generation, this is our people survey, it's not happening what it was found to be in the second generation. So second generation is born in Spain, if they feel discriminated, we know that they are going to construct this reactive feeling, reactive identities, but it's not the case for the migrants in the first generation. This sense of belonging to the country of origin or ethnic identities act differently among the foreign-born and the next generation. That is our main conclusion. As I told before, it's a working process